Hey folks, this is Bastion Slot, and in tonight's video we're going to go through that brand new Season 2 trailer for Prehistoric Planet and try to name every single species present. And that is a lot of different species, because there's in total 29 at least different species present throughout the trailer, and even more to come when the show releases officially later this month. Some of these creatures are obscure, hard to name, hard to recognize, so I'm here to help. Though I had plenty of help myself, so thanks again to Fang, True Yi, and Vidax for the help in putting this list together. Right, lots to get through, so let's make it snappy, let's get started. First up, we've got Tarkia, our Mongolian ankylosaurid. Would have been hunted by the Asian tyrannosaurid Tarbosaurus we saw last season. Maybe we'll see Tarbosaurus come back. We can also see it here scaring off some curious pachycephalosaurids that we'll get to a little bit later on. Next in the trailer was Hatsagopteryx, our giant adstarkid from Harteg Island, where it ruled as an apex predator. Then Pachycephalosaurus, the thick-headed lizard from North America, and our best look yet at this new pachycephalosaurid and the new pachycephalosaurids, finally making their debut in Season 2. Nanooksaurus, returning from Season 1, the polar bear lizard, still an awesome name, a tyrannosauroid from Alaska. Next one we think is probably Alamosaurus, the titanosaur from North America. We keep seeing it as a corpse, and this could be finally the debut of its alive version, the largest dinosaur potentially ever seen in North America. Triceratops gets tons of footage here, by far the most featured dinosaur in the trailer, looking incredible here with those gigantic horns and colourful sunburnt variant crests. The huge horns present on that first one that we see is based very specifically on the Yoshi's trike specimen as well, and we can see them here enacting a dominance display. Next up we've got Icesaurus, another titanosaur, this time from India and Pakistan, and it's our first time in that region of the world. Really interesting detail on the baby Icesaurus here, you can see there's a little egg tooth present, which is a temporary sharp point that would allow the dinosaur to break out of the egg. Doesn't the adult look absolutely beautiful? Next up is a little bit up in the air. It could be Pleuridans, which is a mosasaurid from Western Africa. And that includes Morocco, which will lend a little bit more credence to our next guess. But man, the exit animation here with that elasmosaurid in the mouth, very, very cool. And that next guest is Zarathustra. We talked about this a little bit last time. It is a elasmosaurid. We can see it here chasing a bait ball. We don't have a definite idea on this one, but Zarathustra is my personal choice at the very least. Next up, we have our returning Velociraptorine. That's a subfamily of Dromaeosaurus, containing genera like Deinonychus and, of course, Velociraptor. We don't know for sure what we're seeing here with this one. Again, that's been debated since Season 1, so hopefully we can get some clarification in Season 2. We do know what this guy is though, this is Ostroraptor, confirmed to be Ostroraptor by Darren Naish on Twitter. This Argentine Dromaeosaurid was one of the largest of its kind about. And we're back to the Pachycephalosaurids now with Prenocephaly, or at least probably Prenocephaly. This is a very small Pachycephalosaurid from Mongolia, just like the Tarkia that we're seeing here with it batting them away. Beelzebufo also returning from Season 1, the Devil Toad returning to Madagascar and likely protecting its egg clutch from the inadvertent steps of Rapetosaurus, yet another titanosaur. Some real sauropod love this season so far, but again from Madagascar this time. Not a big titanosaur by any stretch, but a very cool kid all the same. A new dinosaur here, we've got Ampero Beta. It's a Peravian from Antarctica. It's a good choice here because it lacks, if you just about glimpse it at the start of the clip, it lacks that telltale sickle claw that would usually be present, but isn't present on Ampero Beta. As for what it's chasing, my personal best guess is Trinisaura, which is an ornithopod of about this size, 5 feet or so long, also from Antarctica, just like Ampero Beta. Ornithomimus is returning here with our Nanooksaurus. He's back, he's hungry, he's chasing down this herd of Ornithomimus coated in those grey and red feathers as we saw in Season 1. Nemetosaurus next up, a sauropod from Mongolia. Lots of love for Africa today as well. Herding alongside here with the, I believe as of yet, unnamed Mongolian titanosaur. So we don't have an official name for that, but it's really cool to see them herding together. And you can really get a glimpse of the vast size difference between the two. Edmontosaurus is here purely so people stop badgering Apple about the Edmontosaurus meme, I'm pretty sure. This is our North American Hadrosaurid. Now we've got Pectinodon, again a little bit of guesswork, but we suggested last time that this fella here was the juvenile of the Pectinodon we also saw in the other trailer, and that's a troodontid from North America. making its debut. Now we've got Tephysiadros. Tephysiadros is an Italian hadrosaurid, our first Italian dinosaur, I believe. And it was quite an important dinosaur, representing a mix of both primitive and derived features, a kind of halfway point in hadrosaur evolution somewhat. Not really halfway, but you get my point. A new one for me personally, this next species, this is Mortenaria, an elasmosaur from Antarctica, seen here breaching a hole in the ice so it can breathe. Credit to Joshua Canupa here for the naming on this one, and yes, I finally watched the video. Zalmoxis is also returning from season 1, and yet again getting into more trouble, more scrapes and scraps. This is our Romanian Rhabdodontid. And this next bit is a little tricky. We've got a ton of ammonites here. Shout out to Vidax and Fang, as mentioned, for their help specifically with this section. So we've got these straight-shelled ones on the left. These are baculites. We've got ones shaped a little bit like a trombone. That's probably Diplomaceras. These small, weird-looking ones on the lower right could well be Nostoceras. And we think there's probably a Sphenodiscus in there as well. This is largely over my head. This is all based on other people, this one. Ammonites is not my area, but those are good people to listen to. Finishing off then with our final two, Tyrannosaurus Rex, the king of the dinosaurs, makes his reappearance here on the beaches, guarding an Alamosaurus corpse. Keep an eye on it for the next clip, but there's a really interesting sort of dash of green on his underbelly. And you'll see that in this bit with the Quetzalcoatlus. Not alone this Quetzalcoatlus, however, two of them have come to take claim of this Alamosaurus corpse for themselves. I'm really excited for this scene. You would definitely back the T-Rex in sort of one-on-one combat, but the Quetz is here to intimidate and scare the Rex off, and there are two of them, so you never know. I'm really curious to see how that one ends. Either way, folks, that is 29 new species, and there's probably one or two more in there in the ammonites. Tons of variation here, lots of returning species, of course, but lots of new species as well. And we think there's probably a few we haven't seen yet. For example, Rajasaurus has yet to make an appearance in any of the trailers. Throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video. It was a pain in the ass to put together, I'm not gonna lie. And again, shout out to True Yi, Fang, and Vidax for the help in putting this list together in the first place. True Yi, in particular, really brought their A game with this one. Obviously, a lot of this is still up for debate, a lot of this is up in the air, but these are the best guesses that we've got, as well, in my community at the very least. Let me know what you think. Which was your favourite creature in the trailer? What are you most excited to see in the official programme? And I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.